Tongkat Ali, otherwise known as Eurycoma longifolia or Malaysian ginseng, translates to Ali's walking stick. It seems to be a promising remedy for boosting testosterone, increasing male fertility, performance, and stress. The plant is indigenous to Malaysia, Indonesia, and Vietnam, and has become widely popular these days in the West, as some have found it to be an aphrodisiac and an adaptogen by some herbalists. In this video, we'll look at what exactly is Tongkat Ali, how it works for testosterone boosting and sexual function in men, and I'll also be going over what you need to know in order to get the most benefits from this supplement, including side effects and dosing, so you don't want to miss this. Stay tuned till the end. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. And without further ado, let's get started. Let's start out with, what is Tongkat Ali? Well, it's a medium-sized slender shrub and it reaches about 10 meters or 33 feet. And most of the supplementation comes from the roots of this plant, which is reported to be rich in bioactive compounds, which should be the focus, such as the quassinoids, canthin 6-1 alkaloids, your β-carboline alkaloids, squalene derivatives, etc. But the one that steals the show is the quassinoids, since they account for a major portion of the root phytochemicals. What was interesting was when they took all the roots, stems, leaves, and even the bark, they were able to isolate about 65 phenolic compounds and about 6 quassinoids, which are a group of nortritriptanoids with a ton of interesting pharmacological properties. In fact, they were seen to inhibit cell growth at nanomolar concentrations, which I thought was fascinating. But how does this work for testosterone? Well, let's take a look. You see, in both men and women, testosterone levels peak between about 25 to 30, then they start to drop approximately 1 to 2% every year. And by the time you're 60, testosterone levels are typically only about 40 to 50% of your youthful levels and may even be lower due to stress, poor diet, exercise, and your sleep patterns, which means the need to maintain a healthy amount of testosterone becomes necessary, especially if you're looking to increasing muscle mass, reduce body fat, having what's known as high psychological vigor, and just improve general well-being. So when they looked at how Tongkat Ali could help, you found some laboratory evidence which showed that Eurycoma peptides and Tongkat Ali stimulated the release of free testosterone from its binding proteins and improved overall hormone profiles. A common misconception is that it stimulates testosterone synthesis, and maybe to an extent it might, but more of it was seen from increasing the release rate of free testosterone from its binding hormone called SHBG, which is known as sex hormone binding globulin. In two other recent studies of young men undergoing a weight training regimen, Tongkat Ali at 100 milligrams per day improved lean body mass and arm circumference to a significantly greater degree compared to a placebo group. Another study looked at men at an average age of 51 with low testosterone levels and found that at 1 month of daily use of Tongkat Ali extract at 200 milligrams a day resulted in a significant improvement in serum testosterone levels and quality of life, with concluding that the plant doesn't work as a testosterone booster like an anabolic steroid would, but rather as a maintainer of normal testosterone levels and as a restorer of normal testosterone levels from low back up to the normal ranges. But what about for sexual function? One of the most famous studies came from a 12-week randomized double-blind placebo-controlled study that for the first time looked at 109 randomized men who demonstrated for a freeze-dried water extract of the roots of the Fista technology version of Tongkat, which did have a collaboration with MIT. They found significant improvements in libido, sexual performance, and satisfaction. The study also found that it had a strong impact on semen volume and sperm motility, which tend to be a problem in men as they age, which affects their fertility. Now that we got the studies for how Tongkat Ali works on testosterone and sexual function, let's take a look at what you need to know about the dosing and the side effects and who it may not even be suited for at all, which is all important to know. As far as the dosing goes, and this is the frustrating part, nowadays you've got so many different kinds of formulas with very little standardization on them. A lot of them have additives mixed with the teas and coffees, and there's over 200 products that are available, so there's a lot to choose from, right? Either in the form of raw crude, root powder, or as capsules mixed with other herbs in the health food market. But what seems to be the theme that is safe to take anywhere from 200 to 400 milligrams a day before or after a meal continuously to a 4-week mark, then you could cycle with it on and off. Some even do 1 week on and 1 week off, but keep in mind that most of the studies were continuous daily use for 4 to 12 weeks for those results that you're looking for. And remember, these supplements aren't regulated by the FDA and may contain hidden ingredients, so it is important that you look for products tested by independent third parties such as USP, NSF International, or the Consumer Lab. A good idea is to be aware of those supplement brands that claim to cure a specific disease or treat symptoms of a specific disease, because chances are they're only out there for your money and they don't care much about you. And as far as the three bizarre side effects go, insomnia, especially at higher doses of 400 to 600 milligrams a day, that could keep you up all night and make it harder for you to fall asleep. The second side effect being irritability, which can lead to aggression and agitation, which the things that you find throughout the day that wouldn't bother you, they start to all of a sudden bother you. And the third side effect is restlessness, which could be that feeling of not feeling fully rested when you need to be, which can make you more irritated. So yes, this channel is about keeping it real and not trying to paint that rosy picture that you get on other channels. So definitely subscribe if you like factual information. Now let's take a look at who should completely avoid Tongkat Ali, because let's face it, it's not safe for everyone. You see, because Tongkat Ali might increase testosterone levels, people at risk or have hormone sensitive cancers or a history of heart disease or kidney disease may have an adverse reaction to the supplement. And based on other studies that we have found in animals, it can lead to a reduced blood glucose in hyperglycemic animals. So the possibility for increasing your blood sugar exists, so it should be cautiously used if you're using it with other medicines that lower blood sugars, because they could either bring them up or down. And also, if you're pregnant or planning to be, or if you're nursing, then avoid it, because there isn't much data to support if it's safe to take it if you are pregnant or planning to be, or if you're a kid. You see, Tongkat Ali has some real promising indications. It's been used for centuries in traditional medicine systems in Southeast Asia for quite some time, and many have benefited from it. And I would love to keep updated with Tongkat to see where this all goes. Click the red subscribe button down below, and I'll see you on the next one.